Hey guys, so as you can tell, I have moved the webcam so that we can actually see my hands in action as we fold things. You won't see my face at this angle, but I figured it's better than what we had the last time because I was so zoomed out. And let's see if the song request queue is working right now. I mean, it'll definitely work for me because I'm the owner. But assemble command SR followed by a YouTube link should... That video's not in the music category, that's weird. And for Nuke Worker 2, really? I thought we fixed this last time. Alright, well, it's time for me to open Nightbot. But hey, Nuke Worker, welcome back. I have a tab of Nightbot open right now, just to be absolutely safe. So I'm just going to make an adjustment. Alright, and since I've made that adjustment, let me see if this works with your link. Nuke Worker, why are you gonna make me regret that? Why? I will allow it this once. Anyways. We're not gonna get to finish this one in the stream, I don't think, but I do imagine we're gonna get a good start, and that's on the car. Last time we were here, I built a submarine. Just gonna skip ahead to yours, Nuke. Oh, there is music in it. Okay, that's passable. I thought it was gonna be just the scream, but at least it has background music. So we're gonna be making the Troy-Con car. Okay, Nuke, on the whole, I trust you, so don't worry about it. There are 7 steps that we need to complete here. And I imagine we'll probably get through most of them today, but probably not all of them, because I do have to end before I need to go to bed for work. So first, we need to make the steering wheel proper. Now that's going to be removing the big sheet, that big piece from sheet A. So now with the new camera angle, you can actually see all the cardboard action up. Close, I'm unfolding this giant sheet, and we're gonna punch out the steering wheel from the inside. Here's a view of the back. It's time to start punching. Okay, is the command working now? This sounds familiar. And just don't mind me, I'm punching some cardboard. Those triangular pieces are not part of the main wheel, so I can separate them. There we go. Piece is out now. Alright, so Nuke, you can actually load up the queue with up to 3 songs at a time. That's what I have it set to right now for individual people, so if you have any more, you can throw them in at any time. You don't have to wait for your first one to finish. Okay, now you can see there are also holes I need to punch out of the piece, like this one in the center. Are there any other pieces I need to remove before I keep going with that? Okay, no. So, just back to punching holes then. Looks like there are plenty of little tab holes for me to punch out all the way around. Yeah, with 3, I figure I don't get a ton of viewers right now, so it's totally fine to have more than one. But sometimes I get a few viewers, so. Plus, you can only copy links so fast. But yeah, I'm just getting all these little holes around the cardboard piece right now. Now there are some bigger holes to punch right around. If you're ever not sure with Labo, you can always look at the front side, and if you see these stripes, that part is supposed to come out. That is a design choice that's been in every Labo. They don't ever tell you that explicitly, but it is true. Stripes mean goodbye. That piece. Any other parts I need to remove from that? It doesn't really look like it. Alright, so over here, more striped pieces that can come out, including the very center. These curvy pieces next to it. And now all the little tab holes all around. This is a good remix of the Salmon Run music, by the way. Props to you, Nuke, for showing it to me, and also props to whoever made it. Alright, so yeah, you can see we're almost done punching holes in this thing. It'll be worth it. For a fully functioning steering wheel. Alright, yeah, I do believe that's all the holes I needed to get, but now I have all these pieces that I want to dispose of, so give me one sec. I forgot to pull my trash can close to me before I started, but it's here now. So all those small pieces can be dealt with. Oh wait, I do see 2 more holes that I missed. There are more tab holes in the center. This one is fresh start, right? The credits for Splatoon 2 story. Okay, let's get to the actual folding now. With big pieces, it helps to have a flat surface. That's why I have this table. Before we turn the piece over, I was getting ahead of myself. I want to crease the fold lines on these 4 tabs. Boop, 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 boop. Now, what do they mean by that exactly? Oh, other side of the piece. Gotcha. Oh, it's the Octo Expansion credits. You gotta admit, they sound similar. So we fold that tab all the way over, and same for the other 3 around it. Okay, folding all of these creases is what helps everything stay in place when you start putting it together. So now we turn around and we do some more folding, this time right over the center. We're gonna push it down. And the other line. Although that one was pretty much folded because the entire sheet used to be folded in the box. Oh, we're gonna fold all the flaps on the right side. That is tedious, but worthwhile. Okay. So yeah, I am just gonna be folding all of these parts down on this side and the little tab piece above it. So, Nuke, how's it been going? Because if I just keep saying what I'm doing with the cardboard, then this is going to be a very boring stream, no matter how good the song requests are. Everything all good on the Nuke end, aside from everything being nuked. I hope you like the look of my hands, because they're not going anywhere anytime soon. Just a couple more folds on this side. Okay, I think that is all of them. Let's fast forward the instructions here and see what comes next. We're almost a quarter of the way through step one. Oh good, once the flaps on the outside are done, we'll fold the inner one. Towards the outside, got it. Okay, so this one is when you fight Agent 3 in the Octo Expansion, yes? Not the secret final boss, because that would be Calamari Incantation, but the actual version that everyone fights if they finish the expansion. Oh, hi, Nuke. While you were gone, I was asking how you were doing, so that's awkward. I've just been folding all around here. Because we have all these flaps on the inside to do now. To give you a closer look, they're all these little tabs just being folded back and creased so that they will stay in place later. Okay, so now that I have folded all 10 of those, yeah, 10. Last but not least, let's crease the big inner flaps and the two smaller flaps on each one. Then this ring will be done. Okay, so we're gonna want to pick up this whole flap. Be firm with the push. Bom, bom, bom. And then they'll tell us to do the one for the opposite side as well. Sorry, the camera's gonna shake because I have it on the same table as all of this, obviously. Actually, I can probably fix that by just backing it up a bit. Now it shouldn't shake as much. Okay, so everything on this side of the ring has been folded, and now we're gonna flip things over and fold all that stuff, because we're almost halfway through step one. This thing will be coming together into a wheel pretty soon. And, like, I mean, it depends if anyone wants to show up. Okay, so once again, I'm just folding. That was hard work. Now we can finally move on to the left-hand ring. Wait, how many fold lines are still left to crease? Ah, this game in its self-referential humor. On this ring, the middle flap is the only one with a little tab on top. Go ahead and fold that too. Okay, so we got that. Don't forget the inside flaps. So if anyone happens to be lurking around, if you like what you see, there's always that follow button as a show of support. I would appreciate it. Or if you want to see any of my archive streams or any of my musical works, they're on my YouTube channel, linked down below. And of course, speaking of music, this whole thing is a song request stream, so you, just like Nukeworker, could be requesting songs with a simple exclamation point SR followed by your YouTube link. Each user can have 3 songs in the queue at a time, and the queue will stop filling at 25 songs. So I don't think we'll have to worry about that limit. So, with this particular piece, it's been tricky to tell which parts are actually supposed to stay on and which ones are going to come off, because they're not all marked with the stripes that I mentioned earlier. It's kind of just to figure it out as you go, but generally, if you're folding the piece of Labo and there's a piece you were supposed to punch out, it'll come out on its own. Especially after you fold it. Alright, so now we're going to fold these 4 tabs on their end. Oops, I got the piece turned around. So I'll fold the little tab in. I don't remember this part of the song. Has that always been there? Have I just not played matches on Brinstar long enough to know that part exists? Oh, I know about this part, though. How often do you really hear this part of Brinstar? What did that say? Now that the fold lines are folded, we can start building right after I take a nap. No? Later then. Okay, let's take that part a little slower. Watch the screen closely. Okay, watch the screen and fold up the 2 big flaps on the inside of the right-hand ring. The 4 smaller flaps should face each other. So if these things aren't standing up on their own, then you should fold them again. You know, it'll be a little firmer that way, but see, things are starting to come together. Fold down the left-hand ring over. Until it comes to rest on the right-hand ring. Thanks, Nuke. By the way, just so you know, don't stress too much if you run out of ideas for songs, because I have the Smash Wii U soundtrack as backup. So anytime the queue runs out of songs, it just goes to random stuff from Smash Wii U, which is an awesome soundtrack in its own right, so. We're never gonna be completely out of songs. But I think it's better if you guys pick the songs that you want to hear instead of just leaving it up to chance. Okay, so now fold each of these four tabs up, then slot them down into the openings below. Okay, so I'm folding that up, there's a small opening right there. So we are going to go up and in. And it said to do that with each of the four. So maybe you can hear that through the mic, the clicking when that cardboard gets into the right place. So once again, hold this tab up, you see the little hole there, and that's going to pop right in. Okay, now we're gonna start on the middle. Time to bring the flaps in together on the outer edge of the wheel. We'll start with the ones in the very middle. In that picture it looks like the tab's on the top. Oh, okay, so we're starting with this part of the middle where the tab's on top. And we're just gonna fold up this flap and slide this tab into that opening at the bottom. So I'm trying to make sure it's in the camera so I'm not exactly seeing what I'm doing. Okay. There, now it's securely in place. And we're gonna go all around the edges of the wheel and do that. So when one tab goes down, another goes up and in. Repeat ad nauseum. Da da da. So, Nuke, have you ever listened to the live performances from the Splatoon soundtrack? Because they do some interesting things with the live performances, and they even add parts to these songs that you would never hear in-game. What do I think of Nasty Majesty? I think the same thing I thought when I first heard it, and that it is freaking awesome. And I still think that. Alright, so now that I've finished closing all that up, it's starting to look more like a solid wheel. But now we've got all this stuff in the middle that I'm gonna have to address. And the steering wheel is almost finished. It kinda looks like a donut, they say. We're gonna flip this over to the orange side. I'm going to need a stumper. I mean, Nuke, you know how much I play Splatoon, right? So you're probably not gonna get a stumper out of that game. Alright, so we're doing the same thing at the inside of the wheel. Tab comes down, and there's another piece that folds up and into it to close it off. And I think once we do that, the steering wheel will be complete. Which would be step one of seven for the car. I think my hands are kind of blocking the most of what I'm doing because, I mean, remember, all of this is on the inside of the wheel right now. But you can kind of see from the directions in the top right corner what's supposed to be happening. Check the backside. Are all four tabs in the middle inserted all the- Ooh! Oh god, I might have pushed too hard on that. But yeah, they're inserted. Alright, because if so, the steering wheel is complete. Because now would be a good time of a break, but yeah, I think we're fine. We've only built one part so far. Don't go losing that. I spent time on it. We'll put that aside for later. Step 2 of 7, the base. We're gonna need sheet B and C, so here's sheet B, we need the whole thing. That'll just fry right off. I believe this one is Shark Fights from the Octo Expansion campaign. No, wait. No, it's not Shark Fights, it's definitely a play on the Calamari Incantation. Spicy Calamari Incantation. Also, my apologies, the chat box usually shows up on my stream and I do have it set there. For some reason, it's not showing up though, so that's something I'll need to look into. Right now, I'm punching holes in appropriate spots on the sheet that I just got. Yeah, okay, so I mean, when it comes to the spicy calamari incantation and the ending of Splatoon 2 in general, I was very not satisfied with it. Octo Expansion's another story. That's when they did it right. But as far as the Octo Canyon campaign that came with the base game, that was a disappointment at the very end. Had some soul stuff throughout. Don't get me wrong, things like the grind rails and all that. It was totally acceptable, but then the ending just kind of flatlined. Then Octo Expansion came and they had a real ending, so good on them. I mean, the spicy version's not terrible, but it doesn't beat the original. At least to me. If you like the spicy version better, then more power to you. Here's the piece I got from sheet C with the one hole punched out. But we're gonna start with the bigger piece. Let's start with the fold lines and flaps along the outside. Crease them one by one, starting with the fold on the right. Now, if you know what you're doing, you don't have to fold these lines in the order that they tell you to. But in general, I follow along because it's not like I've built these before. There are things to like about the spicy incantation, even though I don't think it beats the original. There are things to like about it, even still. But what I think really ruined the ending for me was what they tried to do with Bomb Rush Blush. That is something I won't forgive. And if people like that version of Bomb Rush Blush, then they just see something in it that I can't. Okay, obviously this one is Fly Octo Fly. Which in my Ebb and Flow remix, I did put in a little section based off of this song. But I wanted to focus on the main Ebb and Flow for that remix. Just because I really like the chord progression in that song, but this one is addictive. The Fly Octo Fly version I listened to a billion times after I heard it in-game. Uh, Okay, so I'm still following just various lines within the cardboard. You do get to all the lines in every piece of cardboard at one point or another, and now we're gonna start folding things up. Oh, I see what's gonna happen with these pieces. See that thicker fold line that's being outlined in the directions? That means we're gonna fold over this flap on the inside, and this tab is gonna lock into the hole that's at the bottom of the cardboard there. Just like that. This is what the part we just folded like looks like from behind. Make sure yours looks the same. Mine has a serial number on it, but other than that, it's the same. So I'm just gonna go ahead and get that piece secured as well. Now that the sandwiching is done, we need to pull down this big flap in the middle, pop tabs on either side down into the opening. There we go, it's now a complete edge. Okay, so let's fold up this part with the pointy end. Oh, and those pointy ends come together, making a hexagonal base, but it's an irregular hexagon. And we are once again going to sandwich those parts by folding down on the tab so that it locks them into place. That one has a cool little edgy aesthetic to it. Okay, this is one of the mission themes from Octo Expansion. I want to say 8-Ball. Alright, we'll flip the whole piece over and check from the side to make sure that nothing's been left out. Check the 6 tabs we popped into the openings. If they haven't popped back into place, go fix them. 1, 2, 3, 4. You can see them sticking out down here. 5, 6. If the 6 turtle heads are all peeking out, we're ready to move on. Alright, it's time for the other piece to make its debut. We got 4 lines to fold. 1. A 2. A 3. And a 4. I mean, the nice thing about the Labo instructions is that, I mean, once you've done a bunch of them, like I did the first 2 kits pretty much on my own, once you've done a bunch of them, you start seeing the patterns and how the cardboard folds. But then also, you can just look at any angle you want. You can always double check to make sure everything looks just like it does in the video at any angle. You can zoom, you can pan. They give you full control there. They'll still stump me. Does that mean I was right about the 8-ball thing? Okay, so now we're gonna bring all 4 sides up. This is from the version 4.0 trailer. I don't know if the name of the song has been officially released yet. Okay. Insert the tabs all at once. Might be tricky, so it's fine to insert them one by one, too. Yeah, now I can. Now I'm gonna rewind for a bit because I want to make sure that the little circle-y part at the end. It's that little bump at the bottom of the circle is going to line up with the little bump at the bottom of this circle. So that's how you know if it's facing the right way. Alright, and we push. We push until the pieces have merged. Fusion ha! That piece seems to be bending a bit. Okay, got it. Gonna have to push to the side and then push it back towards you so that it hooks into place. Not left. It's definitely not pushing straight down, I'll tell you that much. So there we go, connected. Alright, I think this is by the in-game band Wet Floor. What's that called? Anchor Sync? I don't know, but okay, so you might stump me on the regular battle themes because I don't really know the names of most of them. But I recognize this as a regular battle theme, and one of the first ones, in fact, from Splatoon 2. Okay, so it's called Endolphin Surge. Actually, I should know that one because, I should have really known the name of that one because Mondu has brought it up in conversation. He says he really likes this one. I should have remembered he said that. I should have been able to get the name. Alright, so now I'm punching out this part that looks like it has robot claws. See right there? Like right here is where I'm seeing the robot claw resemblance. Now those are not holes, those are tabs, so those must stay. If you're not sure whether or not something is a hole that you need to punch out, then just push on it. If it gives you resistance, it's a tab and it needs to stay there, but if it just comes out, it's a hole. I've never had any issues where I've punched holes that weren't supposed to be there. Alright, now that we've got our new pieces, we'll start it. They're calling it a crab friend. Don't fold anything that doesn't have a fold line. The bits in the picture should not be folded. There's a reason they don't have fold lines. Okay, wait, I know this. This is the battle theme from Final Fantasy VII as heard in Super Smash Bros., right? Oh wait, that means that the queue ran out, didn't it? That's why we're hearing Smash. Anyway, we're gonna fold all the claws over. Wait, no, this isn't Final Fantasy, this is Xenoblade. I should know all the Xenoblade songs, I've played that game. Okay, that was tricky, but we managed. Now we'll fold the small tab on the right side and the thin flap on the left side. Yeah, I think the official name of this one is Time to Fight. So, Nuke, did I tell you that I have a new job now? Been looking for a while, but it finally happened. Not full time, but it could turn into one. Alright, if you found a good one, then I will look away from chat for a little bit, because I've been looking away from chat whenever you're requesting songs, because I know you want me to try and guess them, but Nightbot always pops up the name of the song, so if I was looking at chat, I would have an unfair advantage. Namely, I would know their answer. We're also gonna fold the claws down. Oh, wait. Onto the building. Fold down the crab's left claw so that it touches the rest of the piece. Right, so you can see the orange there. Now we're gonna fold this square up, which I almost thought was a hole that I needed to punch out, but it turns out that it's actually a tab that we're gonna fold up so that the claw stays down. And we're gonna do the same on the right. Mondo's reading! I don't have any sort of raid message or pop-up or whatever, but yeah! Woo! Raid! Raid heaven! I'm in raid heaven! Now I gotta sing this song every time I get raided! Oh yeah, but I'm gonna forget it! Pac-Man is roaring! He's ready for battle. Nuke Worker's been trying to stump me with some of his songs because I haven't been looking at Nightbot and I've been able to guess what songs he requests, but they've all been from Splatoon, so of course I've known them. Anyway, you can see I changed the camera here, so now it's my hands. Hi, guys. Hi guys, I'm Mr. Chatty Hat. I've replaced Azran full time. Because we're building Labo. And you should be able to see me full. Alright, we're gonna roll the piece up. Until it looks like that. So there's me rolling it up. And this tab is going to come up. Ooh, my clock came down. This is the Salmon Run Battle theme. I mean, remixed, of course, but the Salmon Run Battle theme. It's like the regular old battle theme when you're fighting mooks. We made a steering column. And we'll be attaching that to the steering wheel that I made earlier. Wah. I'm just gonna move the base aside. And yes, Mondu, I do believe I fixed the command. I took a look at it after last night's, after the last Labo stream, so, hopefully that helps. So we're going to fold down these two orange tabs in the middle of the steering wheel, make that hole bigger for our steering column. Before you insert it, make sure it faces the same way as on the screen. That is with the T image on the inside facing here. And also you can tell from the colors, the brown is lining up and the orange is lining up. This is the right way, but it can be reversed. It can be that you could flip it 180 and it would do the same thing. They did have that design sensibility with the key. Push the steering column down through the wheel until it's sitting like this. Down here, now it's on the opposite end of the wheel. The thumb gets a perfect fit. What a beautiful union. I still love the humor in the instructions. I'm almost sorry I haven't been reading more. Okay, so our base is back. Alright, lift up the steering cart and insert it into the base. Insertion complete. Look at that, guys. Wait. Now, they wanted me to do it in slow motion, but I don't got time for that. We're gonna turn the whole thing over. They're not fixed together, so we've gotta hold everything in place ourselves. Just like so. And this is where our locking mechanisms come in. So, with all the pieces like this, you fold in half and then you're gonna insert them into some space to prevent things from moving around. Oh, come on, guys, the Star Wars theme. The Imperial March, I should say. Fun fact, I once played this song in one of my piano competitions, but I was disqualified because it wasn't on the set list. Now, that wasn't my fault. The piano teacher told me it was on the set list. And I did a dang good job playing it, too. Next, spin the captain around so that his two dents are facing the blabbity blah, and slide him. Wait. Oh, okay, I getcha. Ahoy there, land lovers, this is the captain speaking. You'll want to hold the wheel nice and steady when you turn me. Okay, so I'm gonna get a grip on the wheel down here. And let's turn this thing. Oh, okay, I see. Now that it's diagonal, it's like locking together. So that's what that looks like. You think we'll see a Star Wars for Switch? They would be... There's actually a lightsaber Easter egg in each of the Toy-Con kits. So that would be a very missed opportunity. Turn the Joy-Con into lightsabers. Alright. Captain Cap Turn has four mates on deck. They are called quadruple lock quadruplets. They help keep the captain in his place. So these small pieces are also going to be folded in half. And use to lock more things in the fifth place. You meant Nintendogs? I don't know. I feel like we haven't heard from that franchise in a while, so that feels like less of a surefire thing than Star Wars. Or better yet, the Nintendogs Star Wars crossover on Switch. That is what needs to happen. Alright, we're gonna use these things to lock that, lock into place there, got it. Start it straight down. extra security for the cardboard pieces never hurt anyone. And I want more to shove down there into that tight little space, but that's the point. This is now or never. Now or never, aka the song that plays when you have 1 minute left in a match. At least in Turf War. Alright, now we got these stubby T-shaped pieces. Turn the sweaters over so that they're facing down and crease the lines. Look, they're waving. Hi guys, we're waving. If you look at the instructions right now, I have the flaps moving back and forth.
Back and forth.
Okay, enough of that. Let's attach the first sweater. The arms need to be ready for a hug. And we've turned this whole thing over. Push the arms in all the way. So you can see I'm pushing it in right here. Okay, that arm did not want to cooperate. Okay, there we go. Now I got it. We're gonna have to do the same with the other side. I don't know if I would call this origami, Miss Wizard. It is just... it's more like Lego than anything else. Except with cardboard. Steering part is now secured to the base. Let's make sure everything moves like it should. And I built the Toy-Con key a while ago. So... Toy-Con key for this Toy-Con goes right into the steering wheel. It does not matter which way you slide it in. By spinning the steering wheel. So they always stop you at the end of each step to make sure that the thing you built is functioning as it's supposed to. Because they don't want you going any further unless it works. Must be my lovely font color. Oh, bitch. Sorry, Pac, I'm used to Miss Wizard being the purple one. Yeah, you're right, it was your lovely font color, but it looks good on you, too. Once you're done with the steering wheel, remove the key. The base is finished, and we can take a break, but I'm an idiot, so we're gonna make an engine compartment. Oh, and we're gonna need that bag of special parts. You know, this thing, with all the strings and rubber bands and bolts. Alright, I need sheet B now. So sheet E is another one of these really big sheets that they folded in half just to get it in the box. We're gonna punch out the big piece in the middle. So if I might ask, how do you guys think that, for those of you who were here for the first Labo stream, is this a better camera position? Like, is it better that I'm focusing on this table right here? Or was it better having it zoomed out before? Because if there's ever a Toy-Con Kit 4, then it's good for me to have feedback. Even my blood is yellow. Interesting part of pathology. Yellow is my favorite color, believe it or not. I mean, I do own the yellow Joy-Con for a reason. Okay, so like with many of these big pieces, we've got plenty of holes. Darker color on the table, I think I can actually do that. Matt, give me 1 second. Alright, I've got your darker color, Mondo. I got this dark blue blanket that I can just drape over the table here. Hopefully that is decently dark. Now we bring the cardboard back in, and there we go. Bomb rush splash. you know what? I think I'll get the rest of these holes once we get to the folding, because I'm starting to wonder which ones are holes and which ones are not. Alright, the engine compartment. So now it's a lot easier to tell where the holes are supposed to be. Which again, these strike pieces can come out pretty much every time. That circle, parts around it. Another circle.
I'm Richard Blade, and we're here at the Anaheim Convention Center near
what is this?
California to bring you the rock and roll jam featuring your favorite analog synthesizer band and a ton of skaters.
Hack, what did you do to me? Okay, this is very much in the style of Daft Punk. I don't know if it is Daft Punk. Okay, now I think I got all the holes out. The engine compartment forms the main body of the car. It doesn't really have an engine, but it's fun to pretend. I mean, with the magic of HD Rumble, that pretending gets a lot easier. And no, that was not all the holes. There's a couple more over here. That's fart bar? Am I reading that right? Purposely gave themselves the worst name ever. Okay, sure. That's a hipster thing to do if I've ever heard one. I'm assuming that was so they could avoid ever going mainstream and, you know, losing their unique sound. Freezing all the fold lines. This piece has all sorts of flaps and tabs, so watch the screen while you fold and try not to miss any. Weird. Doesn't look that complicated. People loved the show when they picked up steam, and now people... Okay. Oh, good for them. Now, what's next to fold? Don't forget these three flaps on the far end of the piece. One, two, three, and then down below. Now when the piece is orange on the other side, you can actually see me folding it. That helps a lot. I'm getting this piece. This boop as we've never booped before. That's what they call it when we fold something over and crease it down. Like this. Boop. Says, oh, there's not money left to go. But, yeah, if you're ever gonna get Labo for yourselves, or if you already have, then you already know that you'd better like folded things. That's what gives it its stability. It is essential, and you're gonna be doing a lot of it. But that's why we have the music. Now fold these four flats so they're standing up. So it's not actually electronic, but it's made to sound that way. That is interesting. I like it. Alright, so again, if you fold these pieces the right way, they will stand up a bit on their own. Not like a 90 degree angle, but they do stand. Okay, this is from a Splatoon 1 commercial, nope. This is like the Splatoon 1 TV commercial. Everyone tanning up. Okay, just want to get that tab in. I was connecting the tab over here. Oh, it came out. Easier to do from the top. Make sure the tab firmly locks into the opening, and we're going to do the same thing on the other side. Alright. It's time to introduce the eyelet, which includes the grommet and the washer. I mean, you know things are serious when we're starting to use plastic parts and not just cardboard. You get a lot of experience with these eyelets if you build the robot kit. Alright, so on the side with the Nintendo Switch logo, take the grommet and push it into the hole from the outside. There we go. You want to make sure that the flat part of the washer, and it's a very slight difference. The flat part of the washer connects to the grommet, not the curved part. Or was it the other way around? Let me double check that. Yes, the flat part is what connects. Now you can undo it, like they say, with a coin, and I did have to do that once on the robot kit because I wasn't paying attention. So, speaking from experience, it's definitely not a mistake. It's not irreversible. I try to be careful anyway. I just snapped it together, it can be set aside. Okay. Now I need sheet F. That top left piece on sheet F, I'm trying to punch out, it's bending a little. But luckily it was bending at the point where I'll need to fold it, so it's not too bad. So my 7-year-old sister has done some of these with me. She enjoys it quite a bit, but she can never go for more than like an hour. So, you know, she doesn't want to do all the larger projects in one sitting. In fact, she doesn't even want to think about doing a larger project like this at all. Because she doesn't want it to take multiple sessions, and she doesn't want it to take 2 hours. But all the smaller ones, she's had a good time with. I'm going to make an adjustment to Nightbot real quick, but we should just get to the next song here because people are requesting stuff. Here we go. Maybe it's a pack to bring the classics. Although, I shouldn't talk like that. I never got to play DuckTales NES. Only NES I own right now is the classic. And obviously that game did not get on there, probably due to licensing. So the game wants us to fold back these two flaps. When you're freezing the big fold, be careful not to fold this mushroomy part. Okay, so now it's time to fold that big fold, but not the mushroom part. That's going to be held down by my finger, just to be safe. The rest of it can come up. So see, this part that's sticking out right here, that's what they were saying, don't fold. You know, this track does sound like it could have been put into a Mega Man game if they really wanted it to. Hey, Chuck. How's it going? If you have any songs that you want to hear, it says !SR followed by a YouTube link. You can have up to 3 songs in the queue at once. Otherwise, we're folding up some Labo. I've already made a steering wheel and part of an engine compartment. Okay, now we're going to pre-spec this little piece that you can see sticking up. Lastly, fold the things on the side. Building time. So Start by folding along the central line so the back piece is standing up. Guess it's time to make more sandwiches. Bring the arm up and around, use the other flap to close the sandwich. That flap is going to be tucked into there. And you can tell from what type of line this is that we're going to fold it over. And that locks right into a little hole that was there. And as you can imagine, they're probably going to tell us to do the same thing on the other side. Again, you do get a feel for the pattern of these things once you've done a bunch of them. Well, Jack, we're building the Nintendo Labo car. I don't expect to finish it tonight, because I have a self-administered curfew, shall we say, where if I want to wake up at a reasonable hour and get to my job and not be tired, then I'll have to stop the stream then. But right now, we're still going. And we're going to build as much of that car as we can. Hi, Newberger. Thanks for stopping by, and thanks for the awesome Splatoon music. Hope to see you around real soon. Oh, it's the Wii Fit song. Da-da-da-da. Wii Fit is an underappreciated game that I will probably stream at some point just to prove how good it is. But don't expect that anytime soon, because I live on the second floor of a building with very shaky floors, and so it will probably be one of those after I move out of my parents' place type streams. I haven't tried the online. Mondu was just streaming Mario 3 to try it out on his end. But I'm gonna wait until the next time I want to play Splatoon or something before I sign up. But I will be signing up eventually. Alright, it said not to fold this. It says not to fold that hammer-shaped piece at the top. Yeah. Where is that fold line? See, I can turn the camera and things get a lot better. So we're gonna fold this whole thing over. Now we're gonna fold and turn it around so you can see that we're folding this line the opposite direction, but not the hammer. Hey, the song is catchy. This piece has a surprising number of fold lines. Fold the two flaps on the right side and the little tab on each one. They're not just the big rectangles that you see, but also the little nubs. And boom. Sure not to fold that bit that must be folded. That bit that must not be folded. Okay, but it does come up with the rest of the piece. That tab goes down. And now that rectangle next to it is going to pop up on its own. And two more boots on the left side. I'll do them. No, I can't do them both at once because they would overlap. I mean, it's worth it to me just based on Splatoon alone. And I would say ARMS, but for some reason, a couple months after ARMS came out, I just kept getting non-stop communication errors from that game in particular. I can never even get into a lobby. and I'd like to keep playing that game. Whenever I bring it to people for local play, it is a big favorite. I'm closing up the ends here by pushing in some tabs. But I know they haven't changed the servers in any way, so even with the paid online, I'm sure I'm not going to get to play that game anymore. Again, except locally. Which is fine and all, but yeah. Have you ever tried driving a third of a car? Well, actually, Pac, we can do that right now. That's about a third of the Labo car. Whee! I'm driving it. Okay, I tried it. Gotta try everything once. I'll insert this into the part from before. Bolt the flap at the bottom of the long gap. Yeah, that makes the hole a little bigger. And now the sticky uppy part is at the end. Yeah, we did know about the paid part. I was ready for it, to be sure. But, I mean, I wished it was better when it was free, so let alone when it's paid. Apparently this is a koala's face, if you didn't know. I'm Koala Man. Is the piece facing the same way? No, I put it in upside down. How did that happen? Okay, now it's right side up. This is why it's always good to check on the screen. Everything looks good now. We've got our locking piece, which is just this piece that I've folded in half. That's going to lock in the quote-unquote nose. Push it in from the right side. You hear that nice snap, it's all firmly in place. I love the colorful clothes you wear, and the way the sunlight. Okay, that bit's all done, and we're gonna put it into the engine compartment from before. Which you might not be able to see the whole thing unless I move the camera up. There you go. Alright, these tabs come up. Of course you're picking up Good Vibrations Pack, because we have HD Rumble. Out of the piece. Okay, I was supposed to have it that way where the lug, the washer from before is over here. Alright, so that gets pushed all the way to the back of the engine block. And we will be able to sandwich it in just by folding down these tabs, which will click into a hole below and lock it in place. I'm trying to do a finger wag. Hard to line it up with the camera the way I'm facing. The engine compartment is done. Remember, never go for too long without a break. You say that, but You're right, I'm still going. Making the levers and lever holder, and it's only 9:12 in my time, so we're still good to go. Putting that aside, I need to find sheet D, because I may have lost that in the shuffle. Here it is. Hey, don't do... I hope I don't need that piece anytime soon. Okay. Now we introduce sheet G. But not before we punch out this center hole. We introduce sheet G into the mix, and we need those two pieces with the circles on them. These pieces are honestly not acting all that great. Okay, there are plenty of holes to punch out of these. Always good to use the backside as reference. You can more clearly see where the holes are supposed to come out. So how about that new Super Mario Bros. U Deluxe? You know, people... Okay, here's one thing that I need to straighten out for people. People keep saying they shouldn't have kept the Wii, they shouldn't have kept the U in the title of New Super Mario Bros. U Deluxe. But here's the problem with that. If they called it New Super Mario Bros. Deluxe, then that would have made it sound like they were pointing to porting the original DS. New Super Mario Bros., which didn't have a U attached. So, they had to keep the U in there just to specify that it is the Wii U one, not the original DS one, that is getting ported to Switch. And now they have the ability to port the original one to Switch. I don't know why they ever would. It was a very early DS game, and not like people look back on it fondly. But still, now they can if they want to. The one thing I will say about the original DS version of that game is it had that blue shell power-up where you would get a running start and then you would slide around in a Koopa shell, you could break blocks, and all the other stuff that Koopa shells could do. I think skidding on water was another thing. So I liked that power-up. That was a fun time. You didn't get it very often. But, you know, I wish that made a comeback at some point. Thank you, Pat. You see my point. And if they named it New Super Mario Bros. 4, it would have made it sound like an all-new one. As to my knowledge, there's only been... Never mind. There are four. I was forgetting about Wii for a second. That's the fourth one I was missing. I was thinking of 1, 2, and U, but there was also Wii. The levers are the secret sauce for a lot of the Toy-Con car's cool features. Neat. Right, these two pieces are exactly the same. So it does not matter which one we work with first. I'll work with that one. Right, before we start folding the fold lines again, don't fold the bits that don't have fold lines, like right here at this crevice. We're gonna start just folding the whole thing over itself. Hey, Flame Rocks! I agree with Flame Rocks. The word new was never a really good idea to begin with. So Flame Rocks, I am folding up some cardboard, making a Toy-Con car. If you have any songs you want to hear, you can use exclamation point SR followed by a YouTube link. Nightbot should be able to take up to 3 requests from each user. When there are no songs in the queue, it will automatically go back to the Smash for Wii U soundtrack. And yeah, other than that, I'm just here to get this done, that we can play with some more awesome cardboard toys. Although, I should really do a stream where I show you all the ones that I made in the first place from Toy-Con Kit 1 and 2. Problem with 2 is that, again, I live on the second floor of a very shaky building, so I can't exactly move around in the robot suit this late at night without aggravating some people under me. And I respect those people under me because they're my parents. And sorry, Flame Rocks, I would go for the whole Spotify thing if I could. But, yeah, it is too bad they changed that, because always good to have more options, right? Okay, so now up here, these two pieces are gonna come down, and that tab is gonna go into here. And it's kind of like a totem. Like, guy's head, he's holding something up. This is his long body. Take a moment to be sure that the important bit hasn't been folded at all. And they're talking about this piece down here. It sticks out a bit from the rest, so you want to make sure it's still straight. You can just straighten it out if anything happened along the way. Check the whole thing over, then point this down as far as it will go. And that's a lever, apparently. Now we're going to make the same bit all over again. So the video will go through all the same instructions, just in case you need them. Six-player multiplayer arcade-style beat-em-up. Pac-Man, I'd be down to play that with you, but again, I'm not very good at fighting games in the first place. Of course, I'm gonna stream Smash Ultimate when it comes out, because I have the whole birthday angle, where it does come out on my birthday, so I do plan on saying, "Happy birthday to me!" and doing a Twitch stream of that game at my usual late night time. But that doesn't mean I'll be good at the game. I am a casual player, I enjoy it as a celebration of Nintendo, and occasionally I beat other people. But that's an occasion. Asking me to roll things up, but I didn't fold those lines, so it's not gonna roll up very well. Okay, so yeah, now I'm rolling things up. Once again, this tab is gonna go straight into its hole. That part folds over. Tab into the hole. And down here. Because it is the same piece as before, it's just the second lever. There you go. I knew we could count on you for those specs, Mondo. Just because I watch you doesn't mean that I will actually learn anything from you dissecting the game like that, but I will try. I will try to get better based on whatever knowledge you may try to thrust upon me, but that doesn't mean it'll stick. Because at the end of the day, it's a fighting game, and execution is everything. Especially the execution of your enemies. Alright, we're going to take those two lines I just folded, stand them up a bit. I may have to hold them. And we're gonna get a lever. Slide open the end between the raised pieces. The sticky outy bit on each side pops into the gap here, that's why it had to stay unfolded. Gotcha. That is, I actually can't get it out now because I stuck it in there, but, they're talking about this little piece in the corner. Two rubber bands. Wait, did they say small or big? We'll be using the smaller one. Alright, they did say to keep this bag around. Right, but Mondo, that's what I'm talking about. I can learn the combo, but I probably can't land the combo. That's what I mean by execution. Although, yeah, that was a funny story how I just decided to take your whole Octobrush support set and suddenly S+. I need to play more of that S+ bracket to see if I can actually get closer to X, but problem with that is the whole internet connection. I want to be absolutely sure my internet connection's gonna work so that I don't lose rank just because of it. Alright, so rubber band over, and we're gonna fold down these tabs. They are supposed to lock into place, so why aren't they? There we go. Alright, so now they are locked into place. We'll attach the second lever the same way. Again, it's gonna slide in. Once we're sure it's all the way, we will rubber band the guy. Pac-Man, did that mean you're wearing night guard too? Because at my last dentist appointment, they told me I was starting to grind in my sleep, but oh boy. Now, if I don't wear that head guard, I can wake up with a sore tongue. Who wants that? Oh yeah, I just bit my tongue a bunch of times while I was sleeping. No biggie. I mean, it's not the worst thing that could ever happen, but still. As you can see, it's attached now. Kinda like motorbike handles. Okay, next we'll be squeezing together four fold lines. Watch the screen carefully and try to do the same. Put your fingers on the cardboard colored square. pitch the two sides together. It's okay if they move once you let go. If you heard that ding, that was my grandmother sending me a message. She did a thing that we were trying to do today, so that's awesome. You know, just usual iPad tech-related biz. Alright, so for some reason we had to pinch it like that so that it bends a bit. Yeah, it's got a bit more of a bend to it now. Just be extra sure. I don't know what purpose that serves yet, but it's not the first time I've had to do something like that for a Toy-Con. This is just the beginning. This is a nice stopping point if you'd like to take a break. No, I think I'm just gonna go for another half hour or so. Unless there's another stopping point in like 20 minutes. Because I want to get what I can done. Alright, from Sheet E. Got six smaller pieces. These are examples of pieces that look a lot bigger on screen than they do in the actual cardboard. There's three, but now my version of Sheet E actually ripped in two. That's the piece that fell off the bed earlier, isn't it? Okay, I gotta pick it up. Walking around the other side, picking up the piece. Walking back to the other side. Hooray for me. Okay, now that I've got those six pieces, we also need Sheet F for some longer pieces. Bum bum. Both of them. These will make thin straws that go inside the levers. I take it that's for stability. We will build the straws first. It does not matter which piece you start with, but there are a few holes to be punched. Now there's two over here by the dot in the orange print, and then there are five more in the cardboard colored end. Alright, that should be the five. Face it down. Just so you know, this piece has more of the bits that you shouldn't fold. Oh, good. Okay, so on the two hole end, there are... Wow, okay. Just be careful with this end. That's what it's saying, I guess. Mondo's making jokes. Mondo's making jokes, oh my god, the stable jokes. Alright, so we fold the long piece over. Oh, Pac. Is it because Mega Man is like your 2D rival? Like, your son is the classic guy and Mega Man is trying to steal his thunder? I'm pretty sure he's trying to steal Electman's thunder, not Pac's. Oh, what if Pac-Man was a robot boss? He already has the word man in his name. Yay or nay to... Chalk! I'm the one who's supposed to be making puns here. You know, I don't want you guys to get bored. That was a bad one. Okay, time to start rolling things up. Then bring up the other side and insert the taps. Again, this looks much bigger on your TV screen than when you're actually building it. But yeah, someone get on making Pac-Man a robot boss. Here we go, our four-sided straw thing. Thanks for the face bomb, Chuck. Okay, again, they're gonna be repeating the same set of directions as we go ahead and bolt these, but I gotta punch out the holes again. If I use this picture, it's a lot easier to tell where those holes are. Oh shoot, am I punching out the wrong part? No, that definitely matches the picture. Okay, sorry you're not seeing me punch the holes right now, I just want to do it over the trash can. That piece will come out if it needs to, right? Right, so we just start folding things again. It can be really tricky to fold these thin parts without bending the whole thing, so you want to be extra careful. That's why you see me using all my fingers in piano position, you know, the curved fingers that you use to play the piano keys effectively. Who knew that piano training would help me fold cardboard one day? Yes, Mondo, ban him, good. No, I'm kidding. Okay. Oh, and you know what, Pac? You missed the easiest pun of all. Remember what we're building? Of course we have to make this vehicle out of cardboard. Cardboard. TGS is running right now in something about a romance saga. Okie dokie. Don't forget to fold up the tabs. I did forget to fold up the tabs, so good thing I read the directions. Okay, once again, just gotta roll things into place from both sides. Tab number one goes in and tab number two goes in. Check in time if the special bits got folded, straighten them out. So they were talking about these hammer shaped pieces, you know, bomb, 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 bomb. As long as they still look like hammers, we're good. We'll power our straws with this case that looks like a robot, really? And I guess I can see how that looks like a robot. Yes, Pac, you can't keep huge a news list down. But don't forget about his unrelated party, Hubris. None of us want to end up like that guy, so confident that he... Well, you know. Alright, fold up the robot's legs. And then all the other lines, including arm number one. And the little tab on it, because you can call that the hand. Arm number two, which doesn't have a hand, got amputated in the war. A robot friend has lots of tiny fold lines, so make sure you get them all. So not just this big fold line, but also another one that happens to be directly next to it. And... Never mind. I thought the tab was also going to have a separate one, but it's attached to the one I did beforehand. Alright, that should be all the folds. Oh, hello, Mr. Straw. What are you doing here? Lift up the robot's head. That's the part with the big hole in the middle. He lost that during the war, too. And take the straw and push it through. The robot is fine. It loves straws. Beep. Straws forever. Yum, yum. See what I mean? It lost its brain in the war. And now it's... I probably shouldn't get into what type of treatment this would be. Push the straw until it comes to rest against the robot's head on either side. If the straw is the right way up, which it is according to the picture, you should see openings here at the top. Yeah. So... the whole thing comes up, and this tab goes... Wait, let me see that again. Stand it up. Push this in. There we go. Did I do the same with the other one? Yes. Yes, I did. Push that. I love this song so much. Although it reminds us that Pac-Maze is probably not coming to Smash Ultimate, even though we all wish it would. This part's supposed to be... I can't tell if this part right here is supposed to be doing that, because it doesn't look like it is in the picture. Okay, our robot's work is done. How'd it fold up so small? Oh, we're probably gonna lock that in with a locking piece. Okay. That makes more sense. I'll fold all the fold lines on this. A beefy computer, huh? Okay, push. Push the thing. So we're pushing this piece on. Okay. And then when you least expected it, a tiny locking piece. Fold it in half. Spin the straw, look for the dot. There's the dot. That's where we're gonna lock this in. Yes. Oop, missed the hole. Bar. The first straw has been powered up. Oh my god, the second robot? Oh, we gotta power up the second straw, right. Get ready for more of the same. You might make eggs and toast in your computer. That would sure be an easy way to fry your hardware. Hopefully your data doesn't get scrambled. You know, Pac, I don't know if we can ever really control our hunger as human beings, because there are some days where I swear I eat more than usual, and then I end up hungry earlier. I'm not sure how that works. If I filled my stomach, shouldn't I be less hungry? I'm not talking about right now or anything, I'm just saying sometimes that's how I feel. Okay, in goes the second straw. Shoo-doo, shoo-da-ba-ba, ya-ba-da-da, Mario World music is playing, da 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 da. Okay, so I'm trying to get that tab into the top again like I did the last time, and there we go. That is pretty darn tricky. And fold up the piece with the hole in it, and fold down the piece with the tab in it. The recurring pattern here in the Nintendo Labo universe. Alright, fast forward the instruction. Oh, I wish we did. Wouldn't it be great if we somehow had a way to actually look at our bio clock, although I don't think we would keep it on our wrists. Although, I mean, Apple did have that giant presentation about Apple Watch Series 4 and the whole ECG thing. Maybe they will give us a bio clock. You're talking like grocery carts, Chuck? Okay, so now I just gotta fold this other piece in half again and push it into the hole near the dot with the flip tabs facing up. And that should do it for the second quote-unquote straw. They are identical. Just like you and Nick. Wait, I gotta do this now. Hey guys, welcome to the Gaming Twin Show. This is Chuck and Nick, and we're gonna talk about our huge news list. We don't usually dance like this, but Azran's controlling us now and he's insane. The deadpan reaction from Mondo. Anyone want to clip that? Oh god, the reflective stickers. Oh, this is the part I need to take seriously, and I've thrown myself into a laughing fit. Guys, this takes precision. And there's only one sheet of these stickers. Make sure that your straw is facing the same way with the O mark pointed upward. We're gonna stick three stickers on the narrow end of the straw. Don't peel the stickers yet. Let's do one more check. Okay, so you might think that these holes at the end of the straw are completely useless, but they're gonna help you figure out where the marker sticker needs to go.
Bye, Chuck.
See you around, Chuck. Thanks for hanging out. I'll just stick with this version of you now. Chuck, you've been replaced. This is you now.
What's that, Chuck? You love me.
You can't live without me. Okay. God, I took that to a... That, I regret taking it to that level. Wow. On the marker sticker sheet.
Oh, I'm in.
That shows you exactly where to get the sticker from.
I should have closed the window.
Pat, you said too much, you're next. Back, we will find a piece that resembles you or your son. Then we will see. Okay, we're gonna line up. Well, yeah, okay. With the hole on the end, we are gonna line up the sticker so that the hole is in the middle. focusing. So, something like that. Your stickers don't need to be dead on. I've had them be a little bit slanted, and my other Toy-Con worked fine. But I try to be as good as possible about getting them on straight. Oh, we're using a different size sticker now. Hi, back. Thanks for stopping by. Bye, Mondo. Thanks for stopping by. I think I'll stop after this step, because I also need to go to bed at 10. I don't need to go to bed at 10, but I'm choosing to go to bed at 10 for the sake of doing a better job at work. Okay, we're gonna wrap this one all the way around. That's easy. It says start with the lower flap, so part that's underneath here. So, full 360, that sticker's on there. One sticker left. Okay, this time we can use the same one that I peeled off before. Right end of the sticker should come down on the side of the straw. That only has the bigger sticker on it so far, just like this. So again, covering the hole, because they were very decisive specific with where these holes are supposed to go. Okay, so... Okay, spin the straw around one side at a time, make sure they are correct. So, this side has just the flat, that sticker. That side has the next two. This one has all three. That one has the bottom two. If your marker stickers aren't matching them off, peel them off and then stick them back on with glue. You do not want to use clear tape because that can alter the reflective properties of the stickers and make it not work right. So you do want to have some glue around if you think you're going to mess up. It's a good idea to press the stickers down one last time to make sure they are firmly attached. Yeah, I mean, I will say they don't typically stick for long periods of time. Because, you know the knobs that you make for the Toy-Con piano, they have a bunch of little stickers at the bottom. And those keep peeling up on me, so I really need to get in there with some glue if I expect to keep using it. Oh, hey, that thing we made earlier, we're gonna put this inside. Where's the dot? On top. With the dot on top, you go through the hole. And that's where these holes come in. We're gonna stick this tab into it. And, hey, you can spin it around. And I'm sure that serves some purpose for the IR camera, so that depending on which way it's facing, it'll see different parts of the stickers. Once both tabs are inserted, let's do the same with the second straw. Okay, keep it like this for the time being. And again, we're going to use the same set of three stickers, I'd imagine. And you can see two little bits sticking off the straw at the left. Oh, okay. I gotcha. I thought they were talking about inside the hole. But what they're actually referring to are the two bits here and here. Because those bits, as well as the holes, mark where you should be putting the sticker. And now another fat sticker. It goes all the way around. And finally, other narrow sticker over that hole. Now, in case anyone noticed, there are some stickers missing off of this already. That was from the submarine stream the other day. So, if you're doing the car first, like you probably should be, because the directions do refer back to the car during the submarine. I chose to do the submarine first because it'd be faster. So, if you chose to do the car first, then these stickers would still be on. Alright, checking again. Top two, all three, bottom two, just one. Right. Just one. Top two. All three, bottom two. Yeah. And use glue if you need to reattach any stickers. Don't want to destroy those reflective properties. With the dot facing up. We're gonna do the same thing again and secure this to the rest of the lever they need. We are getting close to being done with step 4. They want me to remove more pieces from sheet G. Alright, they're small. I'll keep going a little bit. There are 6 fold lines on such a little piece. Okay, they want me to fold down these parts individually. And the little tab at the top. Oh, and we're going to fold this back on itself. Insert the stubbier end into the opening on the lever here. Okay, yeah, there are 2 holes at the top. There, we want to insert that. Then we're going to wrap this around. The tab is at the hole and it just needs to go in. There we go. Coming along. Okay, so it gives it a little bit of a dimension here so that it pops up. Kind of like the round part of a handlebar. They did the same thing with the Toy-Con motorbike. And now we gotta do that again. And I'm gonna cheat and fold both sides at the same time. I mean, it's not really cheating, it's just being efficient. So, things go into the opening, and once again... we wrap this whole thing down and around. Get the little tabs into... I mean, it's the top right now because I flipped it over, but the bottom. I want to see something about this. If I pan the camera, the little opening is, huh? Okay, do you see how the thing kind of opens up? Here you can see the separation, but on the screen it looks like the separation there should be in the middle. So, do I have this thing reversed? I'm going to undo those tabs at the bottom and try to put this back in. So just by turning it around, I think I will solve that problem. Yes, yes, okay. Sorry, I'm still thinking about that stupid orbit joke that I made earlier. Okay, so how does this one look? Is the separation also in the middle? Now those are called the clackers, I don't know why. We're gonna put this into the engine compartment. Time to pan the camera back up. Squeeze the brown squares and push the levers up into a V shape. No, that's not the... I guess kinda like that they made. Oh, even more. Then pick up the levers and slide them through each hole on either side. It's the big rectangular holes. Yes, the big rectangular holes. Oh, now I understand the purpose. Now I understand the purpose behind squeezing these parts together is so that it will slit into this little, it slides into that little slit, I should say. It's, this bit's done now, but we've still got a ways to go. It's still only asking me for one more piece right now. We're so close to being done with step 4. I might as well finish it. So, there are holes to be punched out of this piece at the top, the bottom, and 4 squares in the middle. So we're gonna create this fold line, and then get a big marker sticker for, wow, that is a huge marker sticker, compared to all the rest of the marker stickers that I have had to deal with in Labo. This is the biggest one by far, and it goes right on this rectangular piece. That was not about to go on straight. Okay, that's not perfectly straight either, but the fact that this is a large marker sticker means that there's actually more room for error, because it's gonna be harder for the IR camera to miss. Like, it's still on the cardboard, it's still gonna recognize this, even though I can tell it's not quite perfectly lined up. So I can be content with that, then we're gonna fold it over, and it's not actually going to recognize the whole shape, it's gonna see these four squares. Take that whole thing and insert it. And insert it over this tab. Hold this piece down. Oh, the rubber bands. We're gonna take the rubber bands from before and stretch them around this piece. Do the same thing with the other. Man, we're really tightening things up in here. Try pulling each lever, it should snap back. Alright, so pull the lever, I let go, it most certainly snaps back. Got that other one. Better believe it. So I can turn this piece, and we can pull it, yeah, man oh man. Oh yeah, they want you to test out whether or not you can, oh now I get what that piece is called a clacker for, you can hear it click each time you turn it 90 degrees. That's cool. The levers are finished. That is the biggest hurdle for now. Oh, the biggest hurdle now, period. Okay, well, as you can see, I'm on step 5 of 7, but I did say we're not gonna finish the whole car today. You know, I do have other real-world obligations that involved me getting you to sleep at a decent hour. So, thank you so much to everyone who stopped by. I think we had a really fun time here tonight. And you can count on the fact that in the very near future, I will be finishing this car through steps 5 and 6. I would say 7, but every Toy-Con, the final step is just putting in the controller. So 7's not really a step. If you liked what you saw here on Twitch, my YouTube link's in the description, or if you're on YouTube after the fact and you want to see this kind of thing live, then the Twitch link is in the description. So, yeah, either way, the description's the place to go. Okay, hope everyone had a great time like I did. We'll see you another time in the near future. Bye.